Saint Meera or Mirabai. Saint Meera or Mirabai was a great Hindu saint, known for her fearless disregard for social and family conventions in her devotion to Lord Krishna. She was born in the year 1498 into a royal family of Rajasthan in India. She was born during the bhakti movement around the 16th century in India. She was a great devotee of Lord Krishna and wrote hundreds of beautiful devotional poems and sang many kirtans in praise of the Lord. Meera's father and mother died when Meera was around 7 years of age. She was brought up by her grandfather, who was a devout man. From him, Meera received lessons in religion, politics and governance. She was also well educated in music and art. In her devotion to Lord, Meera began to serve the ideal of Lord Krishna as she would serve her husband. Time flew past and Meera's devotion to her Lord grew to such an extent that she began to see herself as married to him. As Meera began to grow up, her guardians began to look for a groom for Meera. In 1516, she was married off to the Crown Prince of Mewar. Meera's husband was initially confused, and in the beginning, he tried to pull Meera back into the worldly life. Soon enough, he began to appreciate her, and before long, a relationship based on friendship and mutual respect began to grow between them. It is said that her husband protected her young wife from all kinds of criticism and encouraged her to write poems. He also built the temple of Lord Krishna within the fort complex so that Meera could serve her Lord at will. Unfortunately, Meera's husband died in a battle in the year 1521. The death had a profound effect on Meera. She not only lost a friend, but also her mentor and her protector. With the death of her husband, Meera began to devote more time to her spiritual practices. She danced and sang for hours in front of the deity in the temple. Devotees, consisting of common people, came from far and wide to listen to her songs. This was not taken kindly by the royal household, and they tried to stop her. She became persecuted by her in-laws for her religious devotion. However, Meera did not let anything to come in her way. She began to concentrate on spiritual practices more and more. Within a short period, her father-in-law too lost his life in a battle, and her brother-in-law became the ruler. He highly disapproved of such public show of devotion and at point of time tried to lock her up inside her quarters. It is also said that on two occasions he even tried to kill her by administering poison. But each time she was miraculously saved. Ultimately, she was sent into exile. Meera first went back to her parental home. However, her relatives too disapproved of her conduct. So Meera decided to leave Rajasthan and go to Vrindavan, where her Lord Krishna had spent her boyhood days. Once in Vrindavan, Meera was free to serve her Lord without restraint. There she led the life of a hermit, writing poems, having discourses with other sages and interacting at will with the devotees. She also undertook pilgrimages, visiting places associated with Lord Krishna. Her popularity began to increase day by day, and everywhere she went, devotees gathered around her in the hope of listening to her words and to hear her sing. She passed her last days at Dwarka, where Lord Krishna and his clan were said to have lived after leaving their original home at Mathura. Here, in 1547, Mirabai left her mortal body to unite with her Lord. It is not exactly known how Mirabai died. According to legends, she merged into the idol of Lord Krishna and became one with him. One of Mirabai's ecstatic songs, as translated by one of India's great saint Paramhans Yoganand, "If by bathing daily God could be realized, sooner would I be a whale in the deep. If by eating roots and fruits he could be known, gladly would I choose the form of a goat. If the counting of rosaries uncovered him, I would say my prayers on mammoth beads. If bowing before stone images unveiled him, a flinty mountain I would humbly worship. If by drinking milk the Lord could be imbibed, many calves and children would know him. If abandoning one's wife could summon him, would not thousands be eunuchs?" Meera Bai knew that to find the divine one, the only indispensable is love.